Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I'm trying something new today, a napkin journal page. This is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat. Check me out on social media. I'll leave the links right underneath the video today for you. This is a beautiful napkin that I received from my friend Chrissy Frew. That goes by Chrissy Crosser, Grandmother's Attic in Australia. Chrissy sent me this gorgeous napkin, eons ago. And it's just been waiting for this special project. I'm using a mixed media art journal book that was handmade and gifted to me by Kimmy Hogan. Each of the pages is a different type of paper for me to try and experiment with. So I'm going to take this napkin and I'm going to take the paper liners from the back of it and I'm going to tear it into the pieces that I want to use on my page, which will be this bottom strip, this large cluster of flowers, and a smaller cluster of flowers, and then just a little individual couple petals of hydrangea that's going to go in the middle. Now I'm going to use gel medium to put these down with. And like I said, this is the first time I've done this. This is the Crafter's Workshop that I'm using. This is a clear gel medium. And I'm just painting on with a paintbrush and going over the napkins, placing them where I think they'll look good. Now, if my video is too fast for you and driving you crazy, in the lower right hand corner is a little cog button. That's the settings. You can hit that and reduce the speed down if you want to. My voice will be wacky, but the video will be slower. This took me almost 2 hours to do. 2 hours would put you all to sleep in Never Never Land. So I cut out bunches and sped it up so you'll get the gist of the idea of what I've done. I took off the excess napkin from around the edges, and now I'm going to use some paint to paint around, hopefully to try to blend the napkins in. I'm using antique linen distress paint to start with. Now, I have gotten a lot of inspiration, and I will put the name of the crafter and a link to her YouTube channel because I know I will not pronounce her name correctly. And she has just been, oh my goodness, she's just a wealth of information on trying to make your napkin fade into the paper. I had trouble because my napkin was black based and I kind of got lost and I didn't know what I should do to try to fade it. You can see I started with a light, but now I'm going to go to some black soot and put that in. And I decided that it definitely was easier to use my finger than it was a paintbrush. I just didn't have very much control with a paintbrush and I felt like I could figure out where I wanted to place this a little bit better with my fingers. I've always been a messy Marvin anyway, so this just added to it. So I'm going around all of them, trying to just pop into the edge of the napkin. I don't like it. It's not what I have in my mind. It's way too dark. But I don't know what to do, you know? So what I do is I just keep playing. I just keep adding stuff to it. Now I knew I wanted it framed with the black, so that was okay. And then I'm adding more of the cream with my fingers into it, and I just kept playing. I just kept adding. I kept trying different techniques. Now I've got a baby wipe, and I really kind of liked the way that feathered it out. Wasn't so, it had some movement to it there. So I just used the baby wipe, and I used a lot of those because those came in handy. And I had put that gel medium over the top of my napkin, so I didn't have to worry that I was going to rub them and tear them or anything else. Now, I'm going to back again with that antique linen because it's dark. It's just dark, and I'm not a happy camper. This, I guess I must have had something in my mind, but I didn't know what it was. Now I decided, well, why don't I try a color? So there's purple here, so I'm going to do seedless preserves and put that in. And I'm going to use just a dab of the blueprint sketch to change it with just a hint of the blue like the hydrangeas have here. I'm going to start with my brush and then I'm going to finish it with my fingertip. And you know, I liked the purple much better. It just gave some life instead of that blahy black. And I just keep playing, just keep working it in and around the different pieces. And as I said, this is really outside my comfort zone. I've never done anything like this with the napkins before. So, but I'm happy with the end result. It's not exactly what I had wanted, but next time will be better. I was very limited on the napkins I had. I had this one and one other one that had small little butterflies and stuff on it. So I really have to go napkin shopping to try to find some that have larger prints on them that I can use on the art journal pages. Now I'm using the baby wipe and I'm making it smooth this time to see if maybe I like that. Then I decided, well, I'm just going to dab it around, and I really like that effect. Just dab, 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 where it picked up that little pieces of across the bottom. And then I figured, well, if it was good with the purple, let's go back and do it with the cream. And I like this. Boy, I sure found out there's no right, there's no wrong. You just keep playing until you get something you like, because you're the one that you're trying to make happy. Now, I have this Prima stencil. I have a lot of stencils. I haven't used them very much, but this one is lace, and I'm going to use some Faber-Castell. It's called Whipped Soufflé, or Whipped Spackle, excuse me. And I loved how this turned out. Just loved it. Now, I have taken my heat tool, my heat gun, and dried everything really good in between here. I just didn't want you to see the heat gun in motion. You know what that does. And I'm just going to do the two corners, the lower right, the lower left and the upper right, in an L shape, bordering them with this design. And I thought this was just a perfect accompaniment to the flowers here. If you haven't used texture paste, oh my goodness, it's like when I first used embossing powder. It's that same kind of feeling, because you get such a neat effect. So now I know that everyone always outlines their stuff, and I'm going through to see what I have, and I have this general sketch and wash pencil. Well, duh, wouldn't you think if it says sketch and wash, you'd realize you probably should use some water or paintbrush with that, and that will activate the pencil. But I didn't even think about that. I was so busy trying to figure out what I could put around these to outline, and it did outline them somewhat. But you'll notice as I go forward, I go around them several times with things. And probably if I knew what I was doing better, it would have been much better to have filled in the petals with some paint and to gone around them with some more shading. But hey, I thought I was doing good figuring out what I was doing here. So I'm not going to be too critical, and I'm certainly not going to hit myself over the head, because everybody's got to start somewhere. And if you haven't done this, if I can do it, you can do it. So if this is something that you've been procrastinating about or thinking about, or it's been in the back of your to-do list, bring it forward and give it a shot. What do you got to lose? If you don't like it, don't show anybody. I wanted to just share because it's such a new adventure for me. Now, I did do a little splatters with the sponge sugar. I'm not a real good splatter person, but that seems to be the thing. Everybody puts splatters on everything. I decided to go around the edges with my file just to take off any of those little bits and pieces that were laying around, because that, I must have OCD or something, because that just really bugs me. So when I cleaned them up and got that done, made me happier. And then I decided that I probably should ink the edges, because I really like the framed edge. What I never thought about when I'm framing this, and you'll see even a bigger goober as we go a little bit further, is I'm using distress ink. Duh, Patty, don't do that. If I put anything else on it, or water or anything, this is gonna move. Now, I didn't have much problem with the outside border, but you'll see what I do in a minute where I really goobered it up. But most everything, it's like my paper crafts, like my cards or anything else, most everything is fixable. And I heard somebody say if it doesn't work, you just put white gesso over it and you start all over again. I wasn't going to do that. No way. So here is, I decided I would just put some water sprinkles on it and see if I could lighten it up just a little bit because it still seemed dark. Okay, now I get creative. I pull out all these great stamps that I bought, never used, and I'm going to put this great crackle. And it's hard to see here. I hope in the pictures maybe you can see it. But this was cool. I love this stamp. But did you notice what I'm using? Duh, the distress ink. What was I thinking? So this created a little bit of problem going forward because it moved. You know, I went to put my quote on, and sure enough, as soon as I hit it with that gel medium, the ink moved. So I fixed it, and probably you wouldn't know that I had done it or had a problem if I didn't tell you, but I'm telling you so that hopefully, now see how cool that looks? With all those lines in it. Oh, I love that. Now, I had off camera, I had gone around all the edges with that DecoArt light buttermilk. And then I cut out a couple of those Kaiserkraft butterflies that I had back, and I went over the top of them with a little bit of gesso and a little bit of gel medium just to kind of so they weren't so shiny and bright. Now, I have hunted everywhere. People, I went through about every piece of paper I have trying to find a quote. And I was getting so frustrated, and I happened to glance, excuse me, to the left of my desk, where I have cut out all kinds of things and stuck them out. And here's this quote. I don't know if somebody sent it to me. I don't know if I found it, but I had printed it on, I think somebody gave it to me because it's printed on craft paper, and then it was matted, too. So I just copied it, and I copied it in color so that the color of the original would come through. Went around it with a distress ink in Gathered Twigs. Yep, distress ink again. I just don't get it. But I've learned. Now, here's where it got nasty. I'm putting that all over in what you can't see because I edited it out. And then I stick it in my jar and I go back to stick it in my jar and I think, what the heck? What are these little black marks? What is this smearing? What is going on? So I have to dig all the black out of the gel medium, and now this is where I came back. Everything's cleaned up now. But that's when I realized, oh, you twit, you used distress ink. No wonder it's moving. So I took a baby wipe after this was all really good and dry, and I wiped out all that distress ink that I had used the crackle paste with, or the crackle stamp with, and you'll see how I fixed it. I'm just making sure that everything is really tight because I don't want this to come up. I hope to have this book for a long time, so where this is the first one, we want to get it as good as possible in there. Trying to figure out where I want this butterfly. And I finally decide right there on the decide. Now I'm going to dry everything really well before I go forward, just to make sure. And I'm kind of happy. It's not, I don't think, what I had in my mind, but I'm not dissatisfied with it. I mean, for my first one, it's okay. Now, here's where I realize what I'd done. So I get out my handy-dandy archival ink that is permanent. I've already wiped as much as the other off if I can, and I'm going to go back with this crackle background stamp, which is really hard to do now that you've got everything down there. And I'm just wiping it off as fast as I can if I put it on any of these areas that I don't want it. I'm going to use a Faber-Castell pit pen in black to go around everything. And I'm going to use a paper stump. By the way, that saying says decide. So do it. Decide. Is this the life you want to live? Is this the person you want to love? Is this the best that you can be? Can you be stronger, kinder, more compassionate? Decide. Breathe in, breathe out, and decide. Oh, I just love that quote. This is what I want in this book, is quotes that resonate to me. So when I pick them up, it'll make me have a happy place. had these Faber-Castell pins forever because I just had to have them because I watch everybody use them and everything, and they've sat in the drawer. So I was really happy to break out a lot of things that have just been sitting there saying, well, you bought me. What are you going to do with me now? I took a smaller tip Faber-Castell pin, and I made the antenna, drew them on. Then I wanted some glimmer, so I went over it with Glimmer Mist in Pearl. And then I had this brand new Deco Arts Galaxy Glitter Solar Flare Orange, which is the perfect color for the middle of my flowers. Oh, that was just perfect. So I got those on. Now I've realized that I should go back with this pen again and the stump. And I still haven't realized that it's wet, you know. I did realize that later, and I don't think I did it on camera. Can't remember. But I'm just keep going over it. So my petals kind of pop more. And the lighting is, it was during the day, but I kept getting reflections. So the lighting, it kind of looks dull or dark. But when I lift it up, you can see that it's really not. It's pretty, pretty good, finally. Okay, I went back over again because some of the edges I had bunged up with the distressed inks or something. I wanted, not pristine, but I wanted that really thick, edgy look to it with the acrylic paint from Deco Art. So I just put it on with my fingers and let it be thicker in some spots, thinner in the others, but I like that edging all around it. Don't you just love that stencil with that texture paste? Oh, that was my favorite part. I think that really added to it. So I'm just making sure that I've got everything covered and I don't have any pieces that look faded. Now here we go. You can see what it looks like. And here are some pictures. So thank you everybody for joining me. Let me know what you think. Leave a comment. Please subscribe, share, hit the like button if you like it. And I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye everybody.